Today's topic is underwater. Underwater, yeah, I don't know. I'm going to the beach in a week's time, and I haven't been there for ages, and maybe that was my instinctive thought to connect it, but underwater is a great theme. Only 2% of the underwater world has been discovered, means like 98% we have no clue about. It's quite exciting, I think. But we don't have to go that deep underwater to find two really, really good movies that deal with that topic. And I want to present them to you. And they are Waterworld and Poseidon. No, they're not. They are Big Blue and Das Boot. So Big Blue from Luc Besson from 1983 is a movie about two champions in free diving and their relationship to each other, and then the woman comes in and well, let's have a look first and I'll tell you then.
Is it here?
Yeah.
Good.
She traveled halfway around the world to find a man she only met once. But this was no ordinary man.
How is he gonna breathe?
He isn't. It's incredible. All the blood is concentrated in his brain. It doesn't even feed his limbs anymore.
It scares me when you look at the sea like that.
He looks strange, doesn't he? You're so crazy about him, you don't see the truth. Don't think of Jacques as a human being. He's from another world.
He was a man about to discover the secret of the Big Blue. Big Blue.
So yeah, that was the trailer, 1980s trailer. It's not action. It's about these two guys who compete with each other, who are friends with each other, and who are, especially the main character, are in love with the water. It's a slow movie. It's all about atmosphere. It's engaging. It's exciting. Fantastic soundtrack, and you should definitely watch that. Now, I mentioned Das Boot before, now I'll bring Das Boot back in. It's actually the same director of Poseidon, it's Wolfgang Petersen, but this is his absolute masterpiece. That's his most beautiful baby, if you want so. And it's about naval warfare, Second World War, German submarine. And the exciting thing is that you really feel like you are on that submarine. Check it out.
Imagine a world in which your ears must be your eyes, where sudden death circles over your head, and your only escape is terror. Columbia Pictures presents the Wolfgang Petersen masterpiece. It's an unforgettable adventure of lost men fighting a lost war on a sea without pity.
So, you can actually feel, once you watch that movie, or hear everywhere in the background, a sonar or radar peeping, hearing torpedoes flashing by. It's not like the trailer, action, 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 but you really, really are one crew member on that ship. And it's quite long. You have to invest an amount of time, but I tell you, the return on your investment, the ROI, is gonna be super high. Now it's gonna be really good. So if you haven't seen it, definitely watch that one. Now, I'm not gonna try to make a very intellectual or clever transition to the next trailer I'm gonna show to you, because it's quite, I think, an important and serious topic, and I'm not gonna mess this up by trying to be funny or entertaining. I've seen that one. It's a very serious topic. It looks like it's gonna be kinda sickening. You wanna watch it, or should I tease you more? So here it is.
But I do wanna say that we try to do the story legally.
There it is. A little town with a really big secret.
It's so bizarre what's going on over here.
When we first got in the country, we had no idea who was following us.
You think they know we're here?
We didn't know if it was the whalers, the Japanese mafia.
Somebody's behind me. I don't know who that is.
They don't like me. They don't like my message.
Rick is world famous for his work with dolphins.
I feel somewhat responsible, because it was the Flipper TV series that created this multi-billion dollar industry.
The dolphin smile is nature's greatest deception. It creates the illusion they're always happy.
You realize after a while they don't really belong in captivity.
I'd never seen so many dolphins before.
The Japanese people don't even know about it.
They take the boats around to the secret cove that nobody could see.
They're afraid of cameras.
They said if the world finds out what goes on here, we'll be shut down.
They were hiding something.
We need to get in there and film exactly what happens. We need to know the truth.
We needed people with a special set of skills to implement this mission.
They're behind me.
Let's go, let's go.
Good luck.
Underwater camera is set.
They're not being told that the free lunch meat that their children are getting are contaminated.
Let it not be said that you didn't know about it. You know about it.
If we can't fix that, there's no hope.
Okay, there's a flashlight. Guards are moving. Guards are moving.
Get out of there. Get out of there now.
Cove, and as you've seen from the trailer, it deals with dolphins, with human beings treating dolphins, and I'm not finger pointing here, I say as a human race, how we deal with animals sometimes, but it's also human beings who try to bring order to this disorder. So again, no finger pointing, no blaming. It looks good, it looks interesting, and I think it's worthwhile your time. Or my time. I can watch it first and then tell you. So that was me underwater. That was the movies underwater, dealing with underwater. And now we should maybe stay there. And don't think I'm trying to make a big joke out of this, but I think I want to cheer you up and don't send you away not feeling good about yourself or today. So here's a clip.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating under the sea.